teaching student myself, Aman. I am going to teach 6th standard history subject, and chapter name is Egyptian civilization, and chapter number 3. So, like the Indus Valley civilization and Mesopotamian civilization, Egyptian civilization is also one of the oldest river valley civilization. It was developed and flourished on the bank of River Nile, because River Nile provided water to the Egyptian civilization for domestic purpose and for transportation and communication. So, Egypt is also called a gift of Nile, because without the River Nile, Egypt would have been a desert. So, next is a Egyptian society, economy and religion. So, like the Indus and Mesopotamian civilization, Egyptian society was also divided into three main classes. The first class included king, nobles, officials and priests, and they lived a luxury life. King was considered as a god, and his statue was placed in the temple, and he was called Pharaoh. Middle class included rich merchants, traders, skilled artisans, jewelers, teachers, doctors, writers. And the third class included slaves and laborers. And the majority of Egyptians belonged to the lowest class. And the next topic is agriculture. Occupation of the Egyptian civilization. Agriculture was the main occupation of Egyptians. Other important occupations were manufacturers of weapons, furniture, jewelry, perfume, glasswork and pottery. And during that time, internal and external trade was also very developed on a large scale. Internal trade was carried on by roads, and whereas external and foreign trade was by the sea. The next one is a religion. Religion was very important feature of Egyptian society. The sun god Ra was the most important god, and Pharaoh was considered as a son of Ra. And some gods were represented by the symbols such as falcon, crocodile, etc. And some other gods were Isis, Orisis, Osiris, Horus, Anubis and Amun. Egyptians believed in life after death. There is a life after death, they believed. So, they developed the art of preserving the body to a great perfection, a process called a mummification. The picture is given in the book Egyptian Mummy. And under the mummification, enabled body was placed in a coffin and put in a pyramid. This is a pyramid. Many objects placed in pyramid with the belief that the dead person may need them, means they have to use them after the death. So Orisis, the lord of afterlife, so was another god worshipped by the Egyptians. So the pyramid were the tombs of pharaohs. So that is a religion, about a religion and the agriculture of Egyptian civilizations. And the next topic of same chapter is the contribution of the Egyptian civilization. So first one is the Egyptian script. Egyptian developed a new system of writing known as hieroglyphics. It was a picture writing system. Picture and sign represent their ideas, means different ideas they represent. So it had about 500 sounds, and Egyptian used a pen made of reed band, and ink was made of gum and soot like a calc, like a stone, coal like. They wrote on a bark strips of a plant called papyrus, like a aquatic plant, and the word paper has its origin in the word papyrus. So Egyptian script was a hieroglyphics, a new system of writing with the help of pen made of reed, gum, soot, and it is called a papyrus. So next one is a pyramids. Next contribution of Egyptian civilization. Pyramid, they are large triangular structures, and the most famous pyramid are situated at Giza near Cairo. And the largest of the pyramid, the Great Pyramid, was built by Pharaoh Chupa in 2650 BC. And it is one of the seven wonders of the world and took 20 years to be built. And the tomb of King Tutankhamun was found intact in 1920. And the pyramid included mostly were tomb of pharaohs. And they contained mummies, cloths, jewelry and many precious items. When Next topic is the contribution of the Egyptian civilization in the field of mathematics, science and medicine. Egyptian made great progress in the arithmetic. They knew about addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. They were also aware about the decimal fractions. They could measure areas, volumes and distance, and they had made a great progress in the field of medicine. Next one is astronomy. Solar calendar was also developed by the Egyptian civilization. They have a great knowledge about season, rains, floods, and they have developed a calendar of 365 days in years of 12 months and each of 30 days, and 5 more days they were added to celebrate the religious festivals. And the next one is the decline. By 1000 BC, Egypt fell on bad days because it was captured by the new powers. Forests were attacked by the invaders. So, Egyptian civilization was declined by 1000 BC. So, thanks and have a nice day.